Welcome back to Go and Preach. We are continuing our study on evangelism, especially planned outreach with churches and organizations, parachurch organizations. We're talking about effective ways that we can reach out as a group, as opposed to personal evangelism, which we covered quite at length for the first number of sessions we were together. So we're talking about corporate outreach. And last week we began looking at open air evangelism and street preaching as an effective tool for sharing the gospel or reaching out to the community. Open air evangelism, very simply, is preaching the gospel to a group of people outside of a building. Now, this can take on many forms. It could be on the streets, it could be in an open field, you could have a sound system. You might not have a sound system. It can be done in a variety of places in different ways. And in reality, it is one of the most simple ways that a church can reach out to a locality. It's very simple to plan an open-air evangelism. It can be as simple as me and my buddy saying, hey, let's go preach the gospel. And we go down to wherever we're going to do it, and we start preaching. It's very simple to organize and put together. Now, one of the reasons that I love open-air evangelism is because, like I said before, there's the time factor. I can preach to many people in a short period of time. And secondly, it's the numbers factor. There's a lot of people that can hear the gospel at once instead of doing it one-on-one. But I have noticed, as I have consulted with different churches in the area of their evangelistic outreach, there is a major flaw in many evangelistic approaches, especially in the United States. And that flaw is, the focus is, let's get people inside of our church building, and then while they're there, we will preach the gospel to them. Now, this is a major flaw because the reality is that the majority of the people that we invite will not come into our church building. I don't know why that is, but that is the fact. T.L. Osborne, famous evangelist, said 90% of the people in this world will never come inside our church buildings. This means that we must take the gospel to them wherever they are. This is so important, and this is where the church at large has missed it. We must go to them. We must share the gospel. Evangelism must take place out where the sinners are. In Luke chapter 14 and verse 23, the Lord, who represents Jesus, said to his servant, "Go out to the highways and hedges and compel them to come in that my house may be filled." But the point is, they were going out to them. Amen. It's very simple for a church to organize, or a parachurch organization, to organize an open-air evangelistic outreach. It doesn't have to be complicated. I already mentioned this before. I encourage local churches and parachurch organizations to find public areas in their city where people gather or where there are large numbers of people passing by. If you have to, seek permission from the police department. But I wouldn't necessarily jump to that, because in our country, we have this beautiful law called the freedom of speech. And we also have the freedom of religion. As long as you are not too close to a private establishment, we have the right to stand outside in a public area and use our voices and to share and preach the gospel. So if you feel like you need to, you can seek permission from the police. If you are doing something illegal, don't worry. I'm sure the police will find you, and you can simply ask them, "Where can I go and exercise my right to freedom of speech?" You will be surprised how compliant they are. We're not trying to cause problems, but sometimes we do have to stand up and remind people that we, in this country, the United States of America, we have the right to stand on the corner, to stand in public places, and preach the gospel. Now, I would recommend for the church to organize a few members to come with you. Maybe you could organize a few songs to sing, or Christmas time is a great time. Go organize Christmas carols. Maybe try it without a sound system at first and just see how it goes. You can begin singing some songs. Maybe some other people in the group are passing out tracks. And after a few minutes of that activity, stop the singing and have a designated person preach the gospel. Share the gospel message with people. Now, I have done this. I have done this many times, and I have found this to be a very, very effective way. I'll share a story. One time in Clearwater, Florida, I was down visiting my alma mater, my Zion Christian University, where I received my education. I was visiting down there, and we, as is the custom when Northerners visit the South, they go and visit the beach. Now, this happened to be in December, and only Northerners are crazy enough to actually get in the water. But while I was there, there were just tons of people walking and walking by. And we teamed up with another group, another church group, and we had guitars, and we were just singing Christmas carols. Here we are in the sunny, balmy weather, the sand behind us, the ocean beating against the beach, and we're singing Christmas carols. It was quite an ordeal. But there were people, tons and tons of people, just walking by, walking by. And it was interesting to me because this group had not originally planned to preach the gospel. They were just going to sing Christmas carols. So I, after we sang a couple songs, I actually tapped the leader on the shoulder and said, "Hey, do you mind if I preach?" And they said, "No, go for it." So here we are on Clearwater Beach, and I start preaching the gospel, the simple message of why Jesus came on Christmas Day and how he died for our sins and he rose again the third day. And I gave an opportunity after preaching for people to respond. And would you know, right here in the United States of America, on the beach, Clearwater, Florida, there were two people who came forward and came up to us and they gave their lives to Jesus. So I'm not trying to make anybody feel bad, but I don't know about your church, but my church does not routinely have two people come and give their lives to Jesus because there are not unsaved people coming to my church. So if we will be effective, we need to go out to where they are and take a step. You know, it might be nerve-wracking. You might not feel great about it the first time that you do it. I get nervous. I still get nervous when I start preaching the gospel in public places. But we do. In this country, we have protection. We have the right. And we have a biblical mandate to go and preach. And we have the rich history of Jesus and John the Baptist, the apostles, John Wesley, George Whitefield, Reinhard Bonnke, all these men who've gone before us, preaching the gospel outdoors. Just think of Jonah as he's running through Nineveh. He's walking through Nineveh. He's crying out with a loud voice, "Repent! For in 40 days the Lord will destroy the city." And the people repented. We need to take back open-air evangelism. We need to grab a hold of, as a church, grab a hold of this vision. Let's start preaching the gospel on the streets of Jamestown, New York, of Falconer, New York, of Buffalo, wherever you are. Let's take it back for Jesus. Come on back next time. We're going to continue talking about open-air evangelism and street preaching. See you next time. God bless.